Welcome to my channel MK Mediguide Lectures, learning with artworks like drawing and calligraphy.
In today's lecture, we will discuss about the cytokine storm and vitamin D deficiency in aged COVID-19 patients. Vitamin D together with vitamin D receptor, his functions such as bone and calcium phosphorus homeostasis, but also have anti-inflammatory and immune regulatory functions. Vitamin D receptor is expressed by several types of immune cells, including monocytes, macrophages, B and T lymphocytes, as well as dendritic cells. By interacting with vitamin D receptor in the nucleus of macrophages, vitamin D can suppress excessive reactive oxygen species production and suppress nuclear factor kappa B function and leads to the decrease in the expression of pro-inflammatory genes such as TNF-alpha, interleukin-6, monocyte chemotactic protein 1, and interleukin-1-beta. Excess reactive oxygen species production can increase nuclear factor kappa B expression in immune cells, leading to excess secretion of pro-inflammatory cytokines, which is discussed in the first part of our lecture. In addition to immune regulatory effects of vitamin D on macrophages, it acts on dendritic cells and suppress the differentiation and migration of these cells. It also decreases the expression of MHC type 2 on dendritic cells. Furthermore, vitamin D can also make a complex with vitamin D receptor and the nucleus of T lymphocytes, leading to suppression of its proliferation. It is testified that vitamin D and vitamin D receptor pathway together have an important anti-inflammatory function, as vitamin D markedly decreases pro-inflammatory cytokines such as TNF-alpha, interferon-gamma, interleukin-1-beta, and interleukin-8, and increases the level of anti-inflammatory cytokines like interleukin-10. Hence, vitamin D can modulate both innate and adaptive immune responses. As elderly adults are at risk for vitamin D deficiency due to several factors, including decreased free vitamin D production, poor skin integrity, decreased dietary intake of vitamin D, obesity, decreased renal function, as well as less time spent outdoors. Hence, the lack of vitamin D in aged subjects are associated with pro-inflammatory phenotype of immune cells, leading to likely increasing the risk of elderly adults with chronic mild inflammation condition. This chronic inflammatory condition likely leads to cytokine storm in elderly COVID-19 patients. In summary, it seems that young adults have balanced between pro-inflammatory and anti-inflammatory cytokines networks. Therefore, their balanced immune system can limit the progression of COVID-19 infection. However, elderly patients do not have the same balanced immune response as young adults, as discussed and shown in this and the other two videos uploaded earlier by us, that with advancing age, the immune system appears to maintain a condition of mild inflammation. So, the activation of the body with pathogens, such as COVID-19 infection, can exaggeratedly increase the amplitude of the immune response, which is known as a cytokine storm. And alteration of ACE2 receptor expression, oxidative stress, adipose tissue, senescent cell activity, and immune senescent cell activity, lack of vitamin D content, as well as decrease of autophagy and mitophagy may contribute to high amplitude of the immune response to external challengers in elderly adults. This high amplitude of the immune response in elderly adults can favor induction of the cytokine storm and death in severe and critical cases of COVID-19 infection. Nevertheless, the COVID-19 infection is not deadly in all elderly patients because the aging process is dependent on several markers, including genes, lifestyles, an individual variety of immune responses to challengers. And with this, thanks for watching our video and support us by subscribing our channel. And do like and comment below about this lecture.